We partner, Roger Swing!
Woo! Balai Sonihal! आया हूं मैं तुझे दुआएं देने, जाग दे रो, जाग दे रो, जाग दे रो। You see, there is a big percentage of people, in fact the majority, we know how to work. We earn a living. And the reason for doing that is, of course, we have to put food on the table. We love our family, so we work hard. So day in, day out, go to work, earn some money, and based on the income that we bring, proportionate to the income that comes in, is the way we live. And the way we live is proportionate to the income that we bring in. But today, tonight, we want to understand why. Why do we work? Why do you work? Why do I work? Small percentage of people who understand why they work have the world directly or indirectly working for them. But maybe less than 5%. So what happened to the majority? See, what do these people know and understand that we don't know? What is the secret? Is there one? So tonight we're going to learn if it is possible, maybe there is a key. The key that can unlock our mind. We are blessed with the hardware already, isn't it? We have the brains. Do you have the brain? We have the brain. You know what is a brain? I hope. But that's the hardware. More important so is having the software, which is the mind. Mind is such that if it's there, then what are you thinking? What are the thoughts? What are you thinking every day? What are your thought pattern? What is the frequency of thought? It's a vibration that you send out to the universe, the mind. But the problem is when we don't even have that thought as a software in the mind, within the brains, and if it's not there, it simply means we cannot land it on the ground because it's not there in the thought in the first place. So we are being blessed with 24 hours a day. We sleep, we eat, we do important things. Yeah? Or sometimes we do necessary things, or we do the important things most of the time. We forget what is necessary, what is more important. So, what do we plant in the thought in the first place? Because there is a saying, it goes this way, what you think is your destiny. The thought is the destiny. That's why it's important to have a vision, a goal, a target, or inverted commas, we call it a dream. Simply stands for what? A dream stands for divine revolution empowering a man and a woman. Divine revolution within you, within ourselves, to raise ourselves. That's why we talk about raising the bar higher. So, divine revolution empowering you. That's the thought. But if it's not even there, you get entangled with important things, necessary things that you think is important, but not all that necessary at the same time. You get involved so much in emotional blackmail that you talk out of a goal, you talk yourself out of working on a target, you talk yourself out because you're so entangled in emotional blackmail that if someone says something to you for a month, you don't forget the matter. And instead of having the focus where it should be, you are disturbed. That's why majority of the people who do not know how to handle the mind rarely makes it. You don't know how to manage the mind, you don't hit the mark. That's why there is a saying, man jite jagji. So it starts with the mind, the software. We are blessed, we are healthy, fine. So there's no harm in being a little wealthy also. That's not a problem, isn't it? To probably get to you to find the true self from within, to draw the attitude in you, to put challenges before you so that the unwanted qualities eventually will become your habits are chipped away so that the habit are fine-tuned to be the best habits that is practice.
We have Gulnur over here.
It's been fun, but now I've got